Hey guys, Jacqueline here this Wednesday afternoon and very excited because, and I have to be on my best behavior, my old boss is joining us on the station this morning. Darren Horn, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. Ms. Jacqueline, how are you?
I am good. Now, obviously, I will be referring to you as Coach Horn for the rest of the time because just saying your name like that was really awkward right then. Now, a lot of you know Coach Horn because of his playing time at Western Kentucky, which I can't go too much into that because we need to keep the ego in check, right, Coach?
Yeah, and plus, I think that happened before you were even born, so I don't know how much detail we can really get into it.
Well, a great
player. I'm getting old.
So am I. You know what's interesting is that I am as old now as you were when you got the head coaching job at Western. How about that?
That is crazy. That is crazy. Hard to believe.
It is. It is hard to believe. So Coach Horn obviously was the head coach at Western Kentucky for many years, his alma mater. And I actually worked for Coach Horn as a student worker. Let's be honest. Best student worker you ever had. Definitely me, right?
Ever. It's not even close. The most talented, the most vibrant, and an outstanding babysitter as well.
Yes, I do. I love his kids too, which they're old now too. I can't believe that. So we're on the phone because we are talking about basketball. Now, Coach Horn does commentating for the SEC Network and will be on the air for the first couple of days for the SEC tournament going on. I guess it kicks off today.
It does. First round starts tonight. I've got all the night games on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday I'll be doing kind of the on-site, you know, deal they do. Actually at the arena for the SEC Network. So we're looking forward to a good week of basketball.
So you are a basketball junkie. You know, you're an X's and O's kind of guy. How excited are you, and how do you kind of expect the play to be SEC tournament this year?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a great tournament, Jacqueline. I really do. I think that, you know, obviously Kentucky has the chance to do something special, being undefeated. I know a lot of your listeners are diehard Kentucky fans, and they've been a ton of fun to watch. I don't have any reason to believe that they won't win three games here in Nashville and win the SEC tournament. But I think the SEC is deeper than it's been in a while. I think, you know, obviously, there's five teams projected, counting Kentucky, to go to the NCAA tournament, maybe a sixth in Texas A&M. And I think the sleeper of all might be Vanderbilt from right here in Nashville. They've got they're playing really well as of late. They've got a lot of good shooters, and they're playing in their hometown. So I think it's going to be a great tournament.
I agree. I think it's so interesting how I think it's funny, I guess, that I see if every team in the SEC that played the same way they play against Kentucky as they do everyone else, what a powerhouse conference the SEC would be.
There's no question. And you know what's funny is I think that's one of the reasons that I think Kentucky has done so well and why I've been so impressed, not just the fact they're undefeated, but looking at it as a coach. They are getting everybody's best shot. I mean, like, every night they play, it's the other team's Super Bowl. I mean, guys make shots that they don't ever make. You know, crowds show up the way they never show up. And it's just, they've taken all of that and still found a way to play well and win close games. And it's been really impressive.
Okay, so let's take a look at Kentucky. Because like you said, the majority of our listeners are diehard Kitty Cat fans. So, going from this point on, you always hear people say, and I'll be honest with you, it drives me crazy, but you always hear people say, oh, it'd be good for them to lose a game. As a former coach and to have that mentality as a player, what is your outlook on that?
Yeah, I don't agree with it either. I don't like it at all. And I think that, you know, there are some cases where maybe, depending on the makeup of your team, its personality, your experience level, where that might be a good thing, like if they were feeling a lot of pressure and not playing well because of it, and your goal is to win the national championship, yeah, I guess you'd rather lose now than in the NCAA tournament. But I don't think this team is like that at all. I mean, at no point as a coach have I watched this Kentucky team play, Jacqueline, and thought, man, they're playing, you know, what I call burden. You know, like, they don't look free out there. They look like they're feeling the pressure. I don't think this team looks like that at all. In fact, I think they're relishing the fact that they've got a chance to do something special, and they're actually thriving on it. And so I think the notion that, oh, they'd be better off if they would lose is really ridiculous. I think, you know, they get a chance to make history, and I think they're bought into that and really looking forward to it.
So what are your – if you had any concerns for Kentucky going on into the NCAA tournament. What would your concerns be for the team?
Yeah, I think it's going to take a monster effort for somebody to beat them. I mean, I think we're talking about historic stuff like when NC State with Jim Valvano beat Potslama Jama from Houston back in 83, or when Villanova beat Georgetown back in 85. All of which happened before you were born. You'll have to look that up on the internet. I think, you know, the only thing that they've struggled with at times, they've had stretches where offensively they haven't been great, and they've had kind of some not all-out droughts like some teams, but, you know, where they just haven't been as good. And on the glass, occasionally, teams offensively will get on them. But I just think the challenge is going to be, you know, they're playing nine guys, and they're wearing teams down. You know, their Georgia game last week's a great example where Georgia played great, could not have played any better in front of a packed house at home. They're up 9 points inside 10 minutes, but, you know, really Kentucky just kind of eventually wore them down and ends up winning by 8, I think. And so, yeah, I think my only major concern would be if, you know, they have a night where shots really don't fall and they have an offensive drought and the other team is, like, you know, playing out of their mind, which, you know, is a good bet will happen. Like you said, everybody gives their best shot to Kentucky.
So basically you're saying if you had the option to take the field or Kentucky, you're taking Kentucky.
Oh, absolutely. All the way to the national championship. I really think they're that good. And I was a guy who was very vocal on the SEC network and radio shows and literally all over the country that said up until about February 1st, they're going to lose. I'm telling you, they're going to lose a game. I had the Mississippi game to open SEC play. They almost lost that one. They almost lost the next one. I thought, they're going to have a night where it just doesn't go right and they're going to lose. But they flipped me because they've just played so well in close games.
Okay, so as we very well know, there are other teams that play basketball in the great Commonwealth of Kentucky. So let's take a look at how you feel about Louisville, where they are, Murray State. I mean, my goodness, if they don't make it into the tournament, I think we're all going to be heartbroken. Western Kentucky, you know, I'm always cheering for the Hilltoppers. I don't care who they're playing. I always think they can win. What are kind of your thoughts about as far as Louisville goes and maybe Murray goes, hopefully Murray getting into the tournament?
Yeah, you know, I think Louisville's not as good as they have been. I think they've struggled offensively. Obviously, they lost a really talented guard, Chris Jones, as well. It's a Rick Pitino coach team. You know, they're still good. You know, could they end up in the Sweet 16? You know, maybe. I don't think they will, and I don't think they'd get beyond that if they did. You know, the Murray State thing is really interesting. I'm on board 100% with Murray State should be in. There's no question they're one of the, you know, 32 or 34 best teams when the at-large bids are handed out. You know, so it's going to be really interesting to see what happens, though, because resume-wise, you know, it's not there. You know, when you start stacking them up in terms of who they played and who they've beaten, but that's not their fault. Nobody will play Murray State, Jacqueline.
They won't
play
that.
You know, I mean, we had a similar situation when I was at Western Kentucky. To get people to come to Diddle Arena, good luck with that. They know there's a good chance that they're going to lose. And so I don't really think that's Murray State's fault. I think they're one of the best teams. I really hope that they get in. And I'm pulling for Western Kentucky. Conference USA tournament starts today. I think they actually play tomorrow, if I'm not mistaken. And, you know, Ray Harper's done a terrific job in March, and hopefully he can do it again.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for joining us today. I know that our Kentucky fans are happy that once again they can travel 65 and go see their Kitty Cats play. I just kind of feel sorry for all the other teams that are always in the SEC tournament because it doesn't really matter. That arena is going to be packed with blue from the bottom of the floor to the top of the rafters. So it's going to be a great tournament, I think.
Yeah, no, I think it will, and it'll be like a home game. And I've been joking with all the people at the network that, you know, aren't from Kentucky and don't really understand it, that there's about to be a big blue mist descend on the city of Nashville. And I'm sure it'll start today, even though they don't play tomorrow. But we're looking forward to a great tournament, so check us out on the SEC network.
Coach, if you need a sideline reporter, you know where to find me.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You're the best.